Now, I understand something unusual happened on Thanksgiving. You went home for Thanksgiving. What happened?
I couldn't feel anything.
And?
And my son and I were in my bedroom, in my son's bedroom, and I realized that I was the devil.
You did what?
I realized I was the devil.
Can you tell me about that? When you say you were the devil, did you feel something unusual?
Like I couldn't get back.
Couldn't get back to where? Back from where?
From everything I thought I loved. When I realized I probably didn't love anything, ever.
One of the unfortunate features of the word depression is it refers both to a normal experience of everyday life and to a disease. And the differences are several. First, the disease occurs as a syndrome. That means that there are a lot of other symptoms that go along with it. In addition, the sadness, the blueness, the melancholy of depression has an interesting specific quality. People who are have the depressive illness will not experience pleasure. They will lose interest in things. Life is gray and boring and dull and weary, which is very different from the pangs of grief. In addition, people have other psychological symptoms and physiological ones as well.
Do you feel sad or unhappy?
I feel nothing.
Do you feel happy? The doctors think that you want to die. Is that true?
I want to die.
Is that true?
Mm-hmm.
Have you told this to your husband?
Yeah.
What does he think about it?
He thinks I'm kidding.
Why do you want to die?
Because I'm the devil.
What does it mean to be the devil?
It just means being really evil.
Have you done something wrong?
I never laughed, I never loved, I never forgave.
In your whole life, you never laughed or
yeah,
loved?
Yeah, I did laugh. I thought I loved.
But you don't feel that way now.
Just look at me.
What about you that's different?
Everything. I smell.
You have a body odor?
Mm-hmm. My hair's falling out. Mm-hmm. I'm disgusting. I'm evil.
In fact, you think that you should be dead. Did you try to kill yourself? Did you really?
Yep.
Tell me about it.
Took a bunch of pills, aspirin.
When was this?
On Thanksgiving.
When Mary attempted suicide, it opened all her feelings to the world. They now were expressed in all their intensity. She was worthless, hopeless. Life was not worth living. She felt she was the devil, and she had the idea that the only way to end this terrible pain was suicide. She tried at home. Her husband brought her right to the hospital. And from that moment on, she had to be monitored. We had to have an individual sit with her 24 hours a day because all she could think of was trying to kill herself. There were hours in the next few days that we had to put Mary into restraints. The alternative was that she would scream and try to kill herself by any device possible. It became necessary to treat her as rapidly and as effectively as we knew how for this drive to suicide and this very severe feeling of unhappiness.
I'm going to clean your head off with water.
It's electroconvulsive therapy. Is a very powerful way to change the mood of individuals who are very severely mood altered. In this treatment, patients put to sleep, and 30 seconds later is given a dose of a muscle relaxant.
Brevetol's going in. The lid reflex is gone.
Cuff is up.
Okay. The bite block is in. Chin up. The impedance is low. Okay.
At that point, electric current is passed between the electrodes in the head. And that takes anywhere from a half a second to 4 seconds.
Treat.
The individual will have a motor movement, what we call a grand mal convulsion. We're interested in that the seizure be of adequate duration, which is between 25 and 120 seconds, in order to be a good or effective treatment.
Mary, open your eyes. Treatment's all over with.
With the severe form of major depression with psychosis that Mary has.
Mary, open your eyes.
In that illness, medication is usually not very helpful. And so the best alternative is electroconvulsive therapy. What do you remember about your depression?
The depression that I came in here with, I don't really remember much about.
Remember nothing about it?
Mm-mm. I do remember going home on, being in the hospital here and going home on Thanksgiving and taking a lot of aspirin. I remember that.
What happened on Thanksgiving?
I remember thinking I was the devil.
Yeah.
And taking aspirin, and then my son coming from my neighbor's house and coming into the bedroom, and then I remember feeling bad that I had done that because I didn't want to die and leave him. And then I told him to go tell his father that I had taken a bottle of aspirin, and then he brought me back to the hospital.
So you have been depressed.
Electrotherapy, or as it's sometimes called, ECT, has a very important place in the treatment of certain depressions. It's not a panacea. It doesn't help everybody. It doesn't help everybody with depression. But by and large, it's probably still the single most effective treatment we have for severe depression.